taxi!
Alice Bradley, Alice Bradley Eddy. I'm American, Lebanese. I am married to a dashing husband whom I love so much. I've been living in Lebanon for more than 30 years. I have made lots of friends, and I run my own business. A business that has changed the face of Biblos. Some of my friends even call me the happiness of Biblos. Perhaps you wonder how all this happened. So this is my story.
Started Eddy Sands 7 years ago. He always wanted to do something for his country. He's very much of a patriot, but he loves Biblos. So what could be the best thing to do? How could we bring tourists? That was the most important thing, was to bring tourists to Lebanon. And so we started. What attracts tourists? The beach does, the sun does, the sand does. Thought of Biblos. Biblos is a sacred place, it's a mythical place, it's a holy place. Tourists would like to come to Lebanon. So why don't we create a place called Biblos Destination? I'm officially the chairman, but actually I'm taking care of all kinds of details. I do all the small touches. I take care of the gardens, I take care of the flowers, I take care of the uniforms, of the waiters, I take care of the cleanliness. I take care of the staff, that they speak languages. That I don't speak Arabic, I speak very little Arabic. So I speak with them in good English and in good French.
En haut, qui est responsable?
Moi, en haut.
En haut et en bas?
Non, en bas, il y a Antoine et Michel.
D'accord,
et moi.
Ok. Merci, merci, yeah. Merci, Walid.
I try to give a very human side to Eddy Sands for both the staff and for the clients.
Ça marche bien? Tu vends beaucoup? Les gens viennent? Ils aiment venir chez toi? Bien sûr qu'ils aiment venir chez toi. Merci, merci bien, merci.
Everything that starts with the E accent aigu is the Eddy world. In Biblos, we have a bookstore which is called Gibran's Lebanon, which is only about Lebanon, anything to do with Lebanon, in English, French, and Arabic. He was a star collector. Also, we have the E boutique, in which I have objects made by Lebanese craftsmen, artists. We have also fashion. We have a shop called Miss E. Miss, because we all want to be young. In a way, I've adopted Biblos, but not for myself. I've adopted it to bring it more like you have a jewel. You want to bring it out, you want to show the best light of this jewel. Thank you.
70s, it was bustling and bubbling, and the Americans loved to come, Europeans loved to come. I was young, I was only 26 then, so I didn't know about all the big parties and everything else. There was the casino, and there was lots happening then. I came to Lebanon in 1973, it was March, and I didn't know anything about Lebanon, but since I love to travel, a former colleague of mine who, when I was working with Time Life Books in Amsterdam, was transferred to Lebanon with her husband, a big journalist from NBC or CBS, one of the big American news groups. And she said, whenever you're between jobs, come and visit me, I'm in Lebanon. So I came to Beirut in 1973. I contacted my friend. So she said, oh, you can't stay in a hotel, you stay with me. We have a nice apartment in the in Ras Beirut. After 3 days of staying with her, she said to me, Alice, this can't continue. I don't know where you go all day. The phone is ringing for you. People are calling you. I don't know who they are. I think you need somebody to take care of you and to follow you, and so I can feel assured. If you want to stay with us, this is it. These are the other conditions. Okay. So, of course, she had her lawyer, who was Roger Edde. So she introduced us to each other. We had a dinner and at her apartment. But she was not matchmaking. It was really just so that she felt reassured. And then the rest is history.
أليس كانت حلوة كتير. كانوا خايفين عليها لأنه بتعرف اللبنانيين بيعشوا وبينجحوا بالتعشيق. فقالوا لما نعرفك على المحامي تبعنا ابن عيلي فينا نأمن لك معه، ما فينا نأمن لك مع حدا تاني. فتعرفنا بهالمناسبة، ظهرنا مرة، من وقت ما ظهرنا من أول مرة بينا سوا على مدى هلأ فوق 35 عام. أنا بنظري بالأول هي تعلقت بلبنان لأنه لبنان بالواقع ملتقى الشرق والغرب، وبيخلي بنت الغرب تشعر إنها بعدها عايشة بمحيط حضاري معين ترتاح إليه، وبالوقت نفسه عم بتعيش كل الإكزوتيسم، كل نوعية الحياة الشرقية مع بهاراتها الثقافية، بهاراتها بالأكل، جمال الطبيعة، المواسم الأربعة، كله هذا كان بيأثر. أنا خليتها تحب لبنان بطريقتين. أول طريقة التزامي الشخصي بلبنانيتي ثقافيا وحضاريا وسياسيا. أنا باعتقادي كمان حاولت محاولة أخرى كانت ناجحة، كنت أعمل مجهود خاص حتى ما تحس إنك غريبة.
The trip that I made to Lebanon as a tourist, as a student, was decisive. I married Roger. We married in 1975. We left actually then. We left in 1975 because the war broke out. But it was normal. It was obvious that we would return one day. A Lebanese can travel, but he is happiest home in his country.
So here we are in our private nurseries above the house in the village of Edde. We started this nursery just for our own private gardens. And then when we started Edde Sands, we continued here. So we've expanded tremendously. All the plants you see at Edde Sands, all of the gardens of Edde Sands have all started here. This is the beginning. This is the reeds from Egypt. Chèvrefeuille. It's a climber.
So at night time you have the scent. This is for the garden, for the chefs in the kitchen. They like to use this for decoration.
Actually, I think I like the outdoors in Lebanon. I like the nature and the mountains, but everything green, flowers green, that's what I like. The garden show is a very nice venue in Lebanon for everything natural. For things that are going back to nature, there is a trend now in Lebanon to go back to nature. So you have the plants, we have good food, but also the garden show is a venue for craftspeople in Lebanon to show what they can do, what the Lebanese can do. As an American, I was not familiar with war. I didn't know what was happening, and so I witnessed the beginning and the build-up. So that was a completely new experience, and there were some ugly incidents that I witnessed at the time. When we married in 1975 and we left, we went to Europe and to the States. It was very difficult for me to understand why my husband was always on the telephone. Why was he always reading the newspaper? And at the same time, it was very passionate to see how the Lebanese, no matter where they were, how they always wanted to know what was happening and the involvement of their country. And now that we've had peace now in Lebanon for a good 10 years, it's wonderful to see all the creativity and to see the energy and to see how people want to get forward, want to get the best out of the experience that they've had. I love the architecture of the old Lebanese houses, and when I first came in the 70s, I said, oh, the similarity between the Italian houses, I didn't know that. I became a member of the Apasad in 1973 when I came to Lebanon, because I've always been interested in architecture, so I've always had that interest. So when I came here and I saw the development starting and people would tear down buildings, old buildings, to build modern ones, I was shocked. I couldn't believe it, because it's so important to keep your heritage. I'm sure there must be ways that these houses like these could be preserved and brought to life again. In other countries in Europe where they've had wars, there are ways where the government can help and they can participate in creating a hotel, restaurant. There must be ways, because this is the heritage of the country. This is not just something personal. It belongs to it's the history of the country. And it could be fixed up again. At least the gardens are fixed up and the trees look nice and clean. Oh, excuse me. Yes, Jill, we're on our way. Hi. Yes, Jill. Yes. We're on our way. We're in Sofar. And we're on our way, okay? So I guess maybe 15 or 20 minutes, something like that, okay?
I met many years ago now. I've been in Lebanon for 11 years, so I'm guessing 8 or 9 years ago, our husbands knew each other and through business connections. So we met down at the beach, actually, I think in Eddi at one point in time. And Alice is a very welcoming person, so she's someone who likes to draw people to her. And I was one of those people. some years ago. Because both of us are American and we've both lived outside the U.S. for a long time, Alice even longer than I have, we have a lot in common. Plus, she has more experience than I do, and I lean on that. She, you know, has a set of skills that I admire very much and that in many ways I try to emulate. She's a woman to be admired in so many ways. Here in Lebanon, and especially in Pamdoun, there is an opportunity to create value which didn't exist before, and it's something that both my husband and I can get a lot of satisfaction from. We moved to Pamdoun with the idea that we would recreate the heritage of the village, which was always vineyards, by making, growing grapes and making wine. Actually, Alice and Roger were one of the first, and their Ed Diard were one of the first restaurants to believe in us, to recognize the quality of our wine, even before we took a gold medal in London. So, you know, that was something, their encouragement among the encouragement of other people was something that helped us to really step up to the next level.
I like that.
Sahtin.
Thank you very much, Jill. I'll be back.
Okay. Okay. Thanks a lot.
Thank you. Okay. The Lebanese social life is a very particular life. It doesn't compare to any social life in any other country I've been. The Lebanese love to go out, they love to party at all levels, from the lowest level right up to the top. I think it's the special effort that they put into their entertainment that makes them different from other people. Personally, as an American, I think American culture is good in certain things, but you have to know what to take from American culture. The things that we were taught in the United States as in the family is, of course, you respect your family, but also you respect your neighbors. You respect your country. And I think that the Lebanese have a lot to learn there. They love their country, but they don't know that they have to do something for it. And I think it's very important that the Lebanese be more active in their love for their country and they take better care of it.
أليس ست حضارية ومودرن بطبعها وبتحب لبنان، ما بتعرف شو بتحب لبنان، بتحب كتير التراث اللبناني، بتزعل كتير بعتقد على تهبيط البيوت القديمة. أنا عطول بسميها لوبونار دو جبال، إلا بكو دوني أجبال، كل محل هيك ناجح بالمنطقة بيكون أليس إلى أصبع فيه. في مثل بالفرنساوي بيقول سي تون دون ريان تون ريان. أليس بتعطي وبتاخد، كتير عاطفية بعطائها وهي ترانسبرانت، قلبها على وشها.
Relationship with Lebanon developed very gradually. I got used to the Lebanese gradually. The Lebanese got used to me. I'm low key. I don't say everything I see. I feel. I show more what I feel rather than saying what I feel.
الفترة اللي قضيتها بإديسانس مع أنها منا كتير طويلة تعلمت كتير أشياء خاصة من مدام إدي. تعلمت انه الامور لازم تكون تاخذها مثل ما هي بكل بساطه. تعلمت اكثر خاصه منا نحب الطبيعه، نقدر الطبيعه. تعلمنا اكثر نكون ممنونين لشو موجود حوالينا، والبساطه هي اكثر شغله تعلمتها منا وخلتني اكثر اتحمس لكل شيء له علاقه بالتراث او كل شيء له علاقه بلبناني. مع انه كمنا امريكانيه بس خلتني انبسط اكثر، اعتز اكثر بلبنانيتي. بحس اللبنانية أكثر من حياة للبناني. لما لما مدام إدي بيسألوها كم ولد عندها بتقول كل الموظفين إدي سانس هن ولادي. بالأخص بعيد الفالنتاينز عيد العشاء حبت مدام إدي تقدم لهم هدية منها هي شخصيا لكل الموظفين. هي نجت تعمل لهم ديكوراسيون وتزبط لهم الكانتين مطرح بيتغدوا بيتعشوا الموظفين تبع إدي سانس. عطينا خبر كل الموظفين إنه في عنا كونكور رسم مين بيعمل أحلى رسمات مش يبقى يرسموا على الحيطان تبع كافيتيريا، ومين بده يطلع بأحلى اسم خلاق كمان أحلى ما يتسمى كانتين لنعطى اسم كمان للمحل اللي بيرتاحوا فيها الموظفين. اشتركوا كتير موظفين بإدي سانس بهالمسابقة وكل واحد سيعرض الرسمات اللي هو عملها. بس مدام إدي ما بتحب يكون بس في ربح واحد، حب يكون كله ربحانين as a teamwork. واستعملنا كل رسمات الموظفين على الحيطان تبع الكافيتيريا تبع إدي سانس. وفي بس أكيد جبرنا نقي اسم واحد للكافيتيريا وسميناها إيه يلا.
There are many things in Lebanon that didn't exist in my life beforehand. The huge family, the Lebanese, they have endless families. We in the West, we have a father, mother, and brother and sister. That's the family. Perhaps a grandfather, grandmother. But here it's a huge family, and you keep meeting people, and they're always related somehow. So it's the sense of family in the greater sense. It's the generosity that you have towards people. People are very generous here. They're very open. They invite you in for a coffee. They invite you in for anything. This openness is wonderful. To people who have given up on Lebanon, I tell them, go out, do something else. See what's happening elsewhere and compare. Go back home and you can see what the wealth is of your country. And Lebanon is so rich, it would be a shame to give up on Lebanon.
أليس مثل ما كانت معي بمشاريعي في الداخل والخارج، مثل ما اليوم موصفة نفسها 100% في الديسانس في الديارد في المشاريع الجديدة اللي عمل نطلقها، موصفة نفسها بمؤسسات السينما اللبناني بالدي وورلد فيستيفال بكلين لبنان المشروع البيئي مشان النظافة اللبنانية. كل هيدي بتاخد من الست أليس وقت كتير، يعني ست أليس كل سنتين عندها مشروع رح توظف نفسها فيه لآخر لحظة من حياتها.
Gracias a la vida me ha dado tanto, me dio dos luceros que cuando los abro.
I have given to Lebanon my generosity, I've given to Lebanon my love for life, my appreciation of what is around me. I have given to Lebanon my sense of art. Lebanon, in return, has given me a wonderful husband and a new home.
Y el canto de todos es mi propio canto. Y el canto de todos es mi propio canto.